been doing lots of activities at the hall here as bushfire recovery, or all sorts of sessions, and I didn't realise how much I enjoyed it, and I didn't realise how much I loved painting and doing things like that until we started doing all these activities here. So in this last workshop that we're doing now, we've been doing haiku poetry, which was really a challenge and fun. And then we put that poem onto to paper. We used text to put that on, and we decorated that page. We've done some origami, and now we're doing some lantern making.
We've tried and use art as a way to reset the brain, and instead of continuing in that trauma kind of mindset where, you know, you might feel a bit of a victim and this thing has happened to you and you're trying to deal with it, and things can trigger, memories can trigger, and you feel all that pain and trauma all over again. And what we were looking at doing is focusing on what nature has done, you know, because when the bushfires went through, you know, and you're looking around at the trees and they're blackened and you're thinking, oh God, and then they start to sprout again, and you're looking at this stump thinking, this is truly dead, you know. Our nature can regenerate like that, and gosh, that's what we humans need to do too.
After the fires, my husband and I, we suffered quite a lot with sort of our mental health, so it's just been so good to be involved with other people and being able to be in a calm, safe environment and be able to just do these activities and work through things like that. So if you're just all sitting around looking at each other and not doing anything creative, it's sort of quite hard to talk about things. But if you've got a paintbrush in your hand and you're doing something, or you know, creating something, you can still sort of talk, but you're not, like, it's not a structured talk.
You know, we didn't used to do all this stuff together, the creative work. We didn't share that experience, and now we do, and we keep doing it. And that coming back to do something creative has been really important for them, I think, and particularly for me, because it's created bonds that were, in some cases, tentative, I suppose, but those bonds go a lot deeper now. It came along at just the right time when people needed to get together, because we needed to get stuff off our chests. When you are bonded with your neighbours, which is our community, then the next time the hard times come, you can support each other through that. Whether it's like, oh God, we need some water out here, can someone bring a pod? And you know those guys, so they're going to help you. Or whether it's just getting together and talking through things, and the friendships wouldn't have deepened in so many cases without the creative workshops. Oh,